morning I woke up and thought, I'm gonna go back to sleep for a little bit. And so I went back to sleep until right when I was told, okay, it's almost sound check time, you gotta wake up. And then I really regretted that decision because I was behind the whole day. I'm one of those people, I like to get up early, get my day started, get a lay of the land, have a good talk with the crew during load-in, figure out the staging, understand what everybody's, you know, problems or whatever is of the day. There's always some issue that, you know, I mean, that's the nature of having a touring production every day. There's always some snafu that you have to get over. So I like to be up and available.
I don't know, I woke up at like 8:30 and I guess the first thought was I need water, but I have tons of water in my bunk, so I just drank some water.
I kind of just go in my bunk. In my bunk, there's a window. I push a button and the window goes down. And so this actually is just like it. This goes down here. And so when I relax, I probably just go in my bunk and get some alone time and just roll the window down and look outside the window when we're driving past the thing, you know, past from venue to venue. And it's very interesting to see, you know, like places that, I remember this from this tour, you know, when you're driving a similar bus routing. But that's how I relax on tour.
Home to me is Southern California. I mean, we're all from Los Angeles, but I actually live in the beach area. It's like Redondo Beach area. It's called the South Bay. And the climate is upper 70s, low 80s all year round. Beautiful girls on the beach. You know, where I'm at too, there's like just bars, and it's called the Strand, where just bars and restaurants on the beach, and it's gorgeous. So that's what I really miss about home.
I guess I look forward to seeing those loved ones that, you know, I've been missing. If I've been gone for a while and there's somebody that, say, you know, my girlfriend, I haven't seen in a long time, I definitely look forward to spending time with her and getting to have some time off. But other than that, I really don't like being off the road. I mean, I'm more comfortable on the road. This is what I do. I love being in the routine.
There was a particular night we had a day off, and I was in Cleveland, and I was sick, and I remember taking some NyQuil, and I went to sleep. And I woke up kind of out of it, and then I took a little bit more NyQuil, not knowing that I just previously took NyQuil, and then I proceeded to hallucinate because I took too much NyQuil, and it was terrible. I couldn't get any sleep, and I was hearing voices, and now I don't take NyQuil anymore. It's terrible stuff.
Average touring day, it just, again, it depends. It's like, we just got here, so I wouldn't say we're like jet lagged still, but our time differences, you know, we'll stay up like super, super late. I mean, I probably go to bed like 6 a.m., 7 a.m., something like that. It's typical though, every time we're here, we sleep on like 2 to 3 hours at a time, sleep 2 or 3 hours, wake up just throughout the entire night. The favorite thing that I have while I'm here is breakfast every morning. We've been staying at like the Radisson Blues, and they have like this amazing spread, this English spread of breakfast that you have, you know, a full English breakfast and all that kind of stuff. And so I wake up at probably like 4 in the morning. If I try to go to bed by midnight or something, I'll wake up at 4, and then we're like waiting at that 6:30 period in the morning to eat breakfast. So that's my highlight of my day, eat breakfast, then go back to bed and get up and shower, work out, and get ready for the show.
I work out a lot, so I try to get my workout in before, you know, all the other bands load in, and you know, so I go in the venue, scope it out, find out where I can do my workout, and you know, we do the typical sound check. We do VIP meet and greets every day. We usually have some sort of press, and then there's the little period after the meet and greet, and then the show where we kind of maybe get an hour to either go take a quick nap or just kind of chill out and you know, just have some downtime. And then about an hour before the show, I'll get my guitar backstage, I start warming up, and then we just start getting pumped up for the show, go do the show, and that's basically it. It's kind of the same thing every day.
We've only had one day off, you know, we're early on the tour, and so seeing sights while we're touring, you know, it's somewhat difficult, and also going to see sites, and then you get recognized and you got to take photos, you know, with stuff when you're trying to take photos yourself of, you know, architecture or art or whatever we're trying to go see. I mean, it proves to be a difficult task. However, I mean, we still try to make as much time to go see, you know, museums and zoos and, you know, all kinds of places, or, you know, influential or, you know, famous places or anything like that, you know, places we want to see, you know. We definitely try to make some time to do that, but it does prove to be difficult.
There definitely is a lot of downtime. You know, even though we do have a pretty busy schedule during the day, there's, you know, it could be, oh, you have an interview today and it's a 15-minute phone interview, and then it's like, okay, we have 2 hours until the meet and greet, so what do you do during that time? You know, like I said, I started working out, you know, and I take that with me on the road. I eat very healthy, so I find that that helps take up a little bit of my time during the day doing that. And then it's going to motivate me to want to shower because I'm all sweaty and gross. So then I take a shower and get ready for the show and everything. And that ends up eating up that day where normally if, you know, I were to not say shower and you're just sitting there all day. A lot of bands have like entertainment rigs with like TVs and Xboxes in them. And it would be great to have something like that. But we don't on this tour right now. We don't have anything like that. So it's a lot of sitting on the phone, scrolling through Twitter, YouTube, looking up stupid videos. CeCe's all about that, the funny video guy. He's always looking at some kind of crazy gallery and has some video to show us, so. But it's a lot of sitting around.
Lots of partying, lots of alcohol, lots of drinking. Yeah, I don't know, getting on with our comrades and the, you know, the support acts that we've gone out. I think it was like the first or second night when we got on tour, we all went out together, bar hopped. It's again enjoying the sights and stuff and going to experiencing the different cultures and things that are around the different cities and countries we go to. So we try as much as we can to get out and hang out with the locals and party with them, you know. Because surprisingly enough, a lot of local people, just regular average people, like to party.
That's such a hard question because I think there's so many good, fond memories, you know. Every day we get people saying that we help them, you know, through their life, you know, or trials and tribulations of their lives, and, you know, whether it's heartbreak or death or, you know, they get bullied or something. I mean, hearing that, and we get that every night in every city. I mean, it's cool to actually hear that you're a positive influence in someone's life, you know, even though you don't really communicate with them. It's just doing something that we do, you know, sharing our art with people. And so, you know, it's hard to pick out a favorite night when that happens every single night, you know, to constantly be reminded that you make an impact in somebody else's life. I mean, that's, you know, if that were to happen to me once, then that would be my favorite night. But for that to continually happen every single night, I mean, I'd say every night's my favorite night.